Hello and welcome back to Proactive New York. Joining me today is Peter Pascali, CEO at PyroGenesis Canada. Peter, it's great to see you. It's been a while. How are you?
You know what? I'm great, Christine. Good to see you too. Thanks for having me on tonight.
Of course. Peter, we have a lot to discuss today. Let's first kick it off with the commercial projects that you've been working on so far. You have an existing client that's intending to purchase three of your DROSRITE systems. In addition to that, you've received a cost estimate request for 36 of your plasma torches from a multi-billion dollar international producer of iron ore pellets. So how are these progressing so far?
So it's very interesting. On the DROSRITE side with the LOI to purchase three 10-ton-a-day systems is very important because it confirms DROSRITE's position in the marketplace on some significant wins. It's an existing client. They're expanding, and that's why we decided to press release the LOI. I mean, we wouldn't normally press release LOIs. They're quite, you know, we get them quite frequently, but in the context of DROSRITE, it just underscores it's the strength of the offering. Now, why an LOI? And I think I can't speak for the client, but given the supply chain issues these days, they like to give us some notice so we can give everybody else notice down the supply chain and make sure everybody's on site and ready to go when they pull the trigger. What's interesting, Christine, is in the aluminum industry, DROSRITE is one aspect where we cover a metal from a valuable stream. But what we're also doing is we're looking downstream at a technology, an existing technology that can repurpose the residues going to landfill, and upstream, creating something, offering something cheaper and reducing greenhouse gases. So that's going to make that upstream and downstream and DROSRITE very, very secure and a very interesting offering. All greenhouse gas reducing or environmentally repurposing residues going to landfill. Then what we're doing separately with an aluminum smelter is repurposing residues that come off of spent pot liners instead of going to landfill into something valuable. So we're getting a formidable presence in the conservative aluminum industry to reduce their greenhouse gases and environmental impact with technologies that are cheaper. And this is key because what we're pushing at PyroGenesis, we say our offerings make sustainability sustainable. In other words, they're cheaper than what you're doing and they reduce greenhouse gases. And you'll find pretty much across the board in all our offerings, that's the case.
So this cost estimate request for the 36 plasma torches, has this progressed?
Yes, it has progressed. Again, you wouldn't press release cost estimates, but again, it was material because it confirms the progress within this particular offering where we are presenting our torches as a way to reduce greenhouse gases by replacing diesel burners with plasma torches. And it was for 36 torches, which is a very specific number. So it means they've actually identified a furnace. And this particular marketplace where we have the patent to replace diesel burners with plasma torches in the iron ore pelletization industry, we estimate to be a $10 billion marketplace. Well, we're talking to three particular clients who have a potential need for over 1,000 of these diesel burner replacing with plasma torches, over 1,000, and we priced those out to be around a minimum $3 million net present value to us per torch. Very interesting marketplace. We have the patent on it. And again, it should be cheaper than what they're doing.
So you do see yourself as somewhat of an emerging leader here in greenhouse gas emissions.
Yes, almost by chance. And to some degrees, in some instances, we're actually repurposing our product line to accentuate that benefit. We're winning contracts. Like in DROSRITE, we've won several contracts already. The last one was a $20 million contract. We never pushed the greenhouse gas reduction benefit. We're winning contracts on its own. Plus, you add in the greenhouse gas reduction, it just adds a strong tailwind into an existing strong pipeline.
I want to end with the most recent contract that you've announced, a $4 million contract with HPQ Silica. Can you talk us through the details on this one?
So so HPQ is an owner of some quartz mines, and what they're trying to do is add value to quartz. And what we've come up with is an interesting, potentially interesting way to convert the quartz in one step into a fumed silica. And a fumed silica is a thickening agent that is used in, you know, toothpaste, paints, cosmetics. And if we're successful, not only will we be able to do it cheaper, but we'll reduce greenhouse gases by 90%. So again, another greenhouse gas reducing offering that will that should, if we're successful, be price competitive against the legacy technologies, which also produce some very hazardous byproducts, which again, we wouldn't produce hazardous byproducts, and we reduce greenhouse gas by 90%. Now, that's not a full-fledged commercial offering. As you mentioned, it's a development project. Its total amount is $5.3 million that comes to us. Part come from government funds. HPQ is paying the largest amount. We also give them the IP that's developed, and they commercialize it. We also have in that particular agreement 10% royalty on revenues, and we can convert that royalty into 50% of the entity that's going to commercialize this if it's we're successful, the fumed silica. So at PyroGenesis, you're getting a lot of commercial, you know, so commercial offerings, but we're also developing future offerings like the HPQ funded $5.3 million funded development project.
Yeah, this is very much related to the government contract that you had announced earlier this year. Is that right?
That's correct. So there was one government agency that stepped in. There's a second one that's stepping in combined for, I think it's around $1.3 million. The balance is put in by HPQ. We put in $175,000, but it comes back to us. So the whole funding is so far $5.3 million. It comes to us, we do the work, and we give the patents to HPQ. HPQ buys the patents as well.
Well, I really appreciate this considerable update from you, Peter. Thanks again.
Thanks a lot, Christine. Look forward to seeing you again.